everybody.
It's Darcy.
And Snacks. We're both here.
Thank you so much for tuning in.
Oh my God, I'm so nervous. This is our first live drag show.
How we doing?
Killing it.
Yes, and we're so happy that you're here. We have an amazing slate of performers for you this evening, which I know you're going to love.
Yes, we're very excited. Sorry, go ahead.
No, go.
We're very excited for all of our performers tonight. We thought of doing this show only in the last few weeks, but we have incredible talent in the Bay Area, and so we were really lucky to be able to put this together really quickly. And obviously, we have a lot of people to thank that we'll be thanking throughout the night to help us make this happen.
Don't forget that, so all of the money tonight is going to the Black Trans Advocacy Coalition and
the No Justice, No Peace Fund in SF. So it's a suggested donation of $10. If anyone's been watching online drag, you're familiar. The donation will go to those organizations, and then each of the performers' tips will be up on the screen for you to donate to tip them as well.
And if you want to give more, feel free. It's all going to great causes and amazing performers.
Totally.
What else is going on?
I don't know. What do you guys normally talk more before we go to the first number?
I think you can do whatever you want to do, Snacks.
Why'd you call it Amplify?
I'm just trying to get a feel, you know. This is our first time doing this.
Get a feel.
I'm going to take a little drink.
Have a drink. What else is going on? Let's see. So, Oasis, we are working on situations where we can open up as soon as possible, so we can be there both for the community and to have a little fun. I know people are getting cooped up, but we're going to make sure to do it all fabulously safe and secure so we can ease back into things.
Totally. Unlike other parts of the country, in case you're tuning in from a different part of the country, I know that our spread is international, but other parts of the country have reopened up, but the Bay Area has not. So we're still in quarantine in a lot of ways.
Snacks and I are in the same viral circle.
Yeah, that sounds really gross.
That's what
it's
they call
though.
It. Or is it viral sphere? Is it?
Biome?
I don't know. What is it? What is it?
Biome?
Biome.
We're in the same environmental circle.
It's not like
circle.
We make out
know.
Or anything, but like we're around.
We literally just started the show.
Pay more and it might happen.
Drink.
Oh my God.
All right. Do you like this? I got this caftan ensemble in Palm Springs a year ago and I have had no opportunity to wear it. What do you think?
Yes, it's gorgeous. It's very rare. Okay, so if you don't know Darcy and I's relationship, I work for Darcy. We're in the same, what did you say?
Viral circle. Also work circle.
And work circle. But it's very rare that she's had something this long and not worn it. So this is a
I've
big,
been holding
big day.
Out. I've been
big
holding
day.
Out. Yeah.
I love it though.
Thank
You're
you.
All about your caftans in quarantine.
Well, I yes.
I knew exactly
I have
what
been
you were
eating
say.
My feelings. I've been eating my feelings a little bit. And I also, you know, I've been enjoying a more comfortable adult appearance now and then.
I love it.
But these are these fabulous caftans that were made from an old 60s pattern that my friend Cutlet in Palm Springs makes. So I'm loving them. I think we need to start the show.
Well, can I tell you where my outfit is from?
Oh, let me guess. Is that Fashion Nova?
Okay, so the jacket is, I think it's Forever 21, actually. Oh, well, no, it's not. It's all Fashion Nova. Why am I acting like
lies,
I wear anything
lies,
else ever?
I was thinking about Forever 21. Like, what happened to all of the jewelry and the clothing? Like, I mean, now that it's out of business, like, how can we...
They still have an online store, I think.
Oh, so I can... I think these might be Forever 21.
Okay.
But maybe not. I don't know.
I don't know. These are from the dollar store in Hayward at Southland.
We should be Forever 51. Right? Shut up!
I think your whole look is Forever 51, dear.
See, that's what I put up with all the time.
I know, now it's on camera.
Oh my God.
So rude.
Forever.
So rude.
On celluloid.
At some point tonight, I'll have to make sure that we see Darcy's shoes as well.
No. Wow. Okay.
We'll take a peek behind the curtain.
And we'll also look at Snacks' midriff.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk about that as the
both,
night goes on.
Both things. Now, can we start
the
show, please?
Yes, let's start the show.
This first performer, I am a giant fan of, and I have been for years, and I'm so glad that she said yes to doing this.
Yes.
You know, I think this queen's a triple threat.
Absolutely.
Dancer, singer, actress.
I have one really quick story about her that I want to tell because I am obsessed. I promise.
Is it
quick.
A bad one?
No, it's a good one.
Oh, okay.
So one night when I was at the Stud for Lizzo's after party after her concert, one of her dancers and her DJ were doing a set there. And Lizzo showed up. And if anyone knows me, they know that I'm like a diehard insane Lizzo fan. And I was like trying to like think of like, is there any excuse for me to like come up to her? She was clearly having fun with her friends. I didn't want to bug her. But this queen just marched right up to her and had a full on like dance break with her. And that is the kind of confidence that I want to carry through all of my life. So.
Without further ado.
You do?
You do? I do. Give it up for Miss Ronnie.
To our show. I love it so much.
Talk about selling a number.
I know. And you know, the great thing about this is Rahni is such a great example of like, you don't need, if you feel like you're a performer who doesn't have like a lot of tech skills or like a lot of like fancy editing stuff, you can just stand and do a number. And when you're an incredible performer like that, you don't need anything else.
I mean, that is the truth because, you know, to really sell a number, you need nothing but your instrument.
Correct.
But, you know, yeah. I will say, though, the jewel on her punani really did help.
It did.
It was an extra bonus.
Yes.
And I think that was where the ruching came up to a slit, I think. But it did catch my eye.
I know. I liked that a lot. They noticed it in the comments I saw.
Okay.
Thank you, Scroto, for pointing that out. Thank you, everyone in the comments. I'm looking at them.
Her hair looks great.
We're supposed to look up here at the camera and not over here at the TV. So
yes,
just a little bit behind the scenes.
Learn your craft.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Has anyone ever talked to Darcy in the dressing room? You want to talk about looking at yourself in the mirror?
Oh, my God. Okay, you're signing an NDA after this.
She's been trying to get me to sign an NDA for years.
This is what I'm worried about.
Never. Oh, never have God. I. Never
Darcy
will I.
Darcy request to be shot from above only?
Oh, yes. Yes. She looks great. Yeah, I thought these sleeves would be a good touch for our shoulder up look today.
Yes, they're good. I need to have more shoulders.
We did not discuss our looks at all, but I think they're very indicative of our two characters.
Yes.
Right?
I think so.
I think so too.
Who's next?
What else are we talking about? You want to talk about something else?
So let's talk about hot trash.
Oh, great.
I started a new weekly kind of social media and all commentary show called Hot Trash that we premiered 3 weeks ago on, or almost 4 weeks ago, on Oasis TV, which is on YouTube. You should all like and subscribe. But it's super fun. I've got a great team, and so you should tune in if you want 11 to 12 minutes of pure, unbridled stupidity.
Sometimes 15 and a half.
Shut up. There's only one time. I mess up a lot.
I was like, the edit ran long. We need to make it shorter next time. The next episode was 3 minutes longer.
Okay, but this one was 3 minutes shorter. It's going to air tomorrow. We tried to air it today, but YouTube dinged us for something we couldn't understand. There's a moment when Sharon Stone's head comes out of my crotch. Do you think that was it?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe it was.
Yeah.
It's hard to say.
I don't know.
It's hard to say.
But we also, spoiler alert, we do a dance breakdown to You're Gonna Lose Your Job, which
yes.
is, I think, the song of the summer.
The viral sensation.
Yeah. It's the song
You're
of the summer.
You're about to lose your job. We definitely do a dance to that.
All right. Let's introduce our next performer.
Okay, great. Let's do it.
Okay. I love this performer, and I've worked together plenty of times. Why are you smiling?
Because I have a special thing to say about this performer.
Okay,
you go first.
So basically, just what we did, this is the exact same setup as last time.
We're figuring it out on the fly, everybody. You see this?
I'm effusive, and then you tell an anecdotal story.
Yeah, I love it.
I
love it.
Okay.
I love it.
Yes, I'm a big fan of this performer as well. We've worked on a number of shows on the Oasis stage and plenty of drag shows on Oasis, too. Even she hosts lots of mothers in the past. And anyway, yes, I love this queen, but I'm not going to say who it is yet, so you can give your anecdotal story.
Thank you.
But spoiler alert, she was amazing in my original rock musical Above and Beyond the Valley of the Ultra Showgirls that China Make It directed yeah. with me, so shout out.
She's a drunk
Why did
Broadway
you put
star?
Shout out in quotes?
Yes. Oh, shout out.
I don't know.
So I'm just doing the out in quotes. Rather than screaming in, then it'd be just like a primal scream, and no one wants to hear that.
Okay.
Can you just tell your anecdotal story?
I'm going to tell my story now.
Oh my God, this is going to be a 5-hour show.
No, we'll get bored by the end. We'll just start jumping through the numbers. This queen is one of my very, very dearest friends. Both on the stage and off, and they were so sweet. They texted me the other day and were like,
oh, yeah.
Can you send me a text of your address? And I was like, are you gonna mail me something? Like, I got like real mail, like snail mail. Can you imagine?
A snail brought you mail?
Yes, it took so long, but it finally arrived, and it was a box from Double Scorpio, and I was like, what is this? My dear friend bought me some Double Scorpio poppers.
But they're actually...
They're not. That's not what they're called.
I'm going to see what they are, actually. It's a gag gift. They're faux poppers. They're foppers. They're actually, if you need to clean your VCR heads.
Right.
Or your... If the VCR in your
Sometimes you can use it for meditation, you know?
Yeah,
it helps you clear
totally,
your mind.
Totally. Not legit. They're not
legit.
Oh,
boy. It's really early in the show for us to get shut down. Hopefully we don't get in trouble for that. Anyway, our next performer is the fabulous
Coco Buttah!
Loves to end a number like this. It's not a read. I love that.
And
it's
she loves cute. Fringe.
She does love Fringe.
I do too.
She loves Fringe.
It's all about the movement. It's all about the movement.
It is. Well, and you know what? Speaking of the movement, is that a weird transition? Speaking of the movement, we also wanted to touch on the fact that we're calling the show Amplify and why that's so important. And for me and for Darcy, I think one thing that we discussed was we wanted to raise money for worthy organizations, specifically ones that, you know, support both our local community, which is why we chose No Justice, No Peace, and also that support our queer community, which is why we chose Black Trans Advocacy Coalition.
And to amplify the queens in our life.
Absolutely. You know? Yes, because it was important to us that we didn't just have a show that we had a bunch of performers in that we were raising money for an organization, but we also want to tip these queens. Please, if you haven't already, tip these queens. I'll make sure that all of their Venmos are on the Facebook event. These are Black performers that deserve your money, quite frankly. They're incredible. And this isn't just about raising money for other organizations. It's about giving money to the beauty that is in our own community and uplifting those performers and amplifying them.
So. And like everyone that's going through it right now, it is sustaining these people through this time. So when we all do get back up and we can be in a live experience again, that they're here for us. So it is, you know, it is about tipping them because they're worthy and they're fabulous and what you see is fabulous, but it's sustaining them to be back on the stage for you when things can open. So that's I know that sounds sort of like brass tacks, but I think it is really crucial to understand that we're all trying to like stay afloat, so when things get back to normal we can be even more fabulous than
completely
before.
Completely. And like I just want to give a special shout out to everyone in the Bay Area drag community, because the support is just overwhelming all of the time for everyone showing up for each other. I think that there's kind of this joke that goes around about how we're all passing the same $10 back and forth. And I think it's true. It would be incredible if Mark Zuckerberg or Jeff Bezos could come in and just give us money so that we didn't have to do this. Yes. But the fact of the matter is, like, we're all here to support each other. And I think that's huge and really important. And the Bay Area is such a great example of community. And
Yeah, because I think, you know, just bouncing off of totally. That, both... you know, the money matters, but it also is an emotional support. Having people tune in to watch what you're doing, having people give you money, even if it's like a dollar, it for someone on the receiving end of that, it is really, really validating and can really keep the fire lit under you as a performer. So don't underestimate what throwing even the smallest amount of money towards somebody, how much that does for someone's emotional sense during this time.
Completely. And I think also, you know, besides just donating money, sharing events, liking events, tuning in, showing up, both for performers, let me put my drink down, both for performers and for the Black Lives Matter movement, you know, going to protests, signing petitions. There are other ways that you can give your time and resources that aren't necessarily about money if you don't have the funds to spare, you know? And again, I have to commend the Bay Area, because I think that we're all so much showing up for each other, both the performers and on the more, you know, yes. larger scale.
The community here is real. Let's get someone else on the screen.
Okay, let's see. Oh yes, of course. So our next performer,
I'll do our thing.
Okay.
Again, I have loved dancing with this performer. I've also loved working with them. They were in our Star Trek Live production and killed it. So I was really happy when they said yes to doing this.
This performer, one of my favorite memories of this performer is a show that we did when I used to host Snacks Bar at Oasis. We did an uninterrupted 20-minute segment of Homecoming from Beyonce. Like, so it was all live Beyonce tracks from Homecoming from her Coachella performance. And this queen did a incredible number. And we should find a time to air that Homecoming show
that.
Also.
I would love that.
But yeah, let's welcome to our virtual stage, Juhnay Arabesque.
Change it for anybody else in your own skin, girl. Your skin just like pearl. It's the best thing in the world. I never change it for anybody else singing.
Agencia. First thing in the morning. When I wake up. Thank God for life. Look in the mirror, say, bitch, I'm the best, 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 best. Way too blessed, 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 blessed. Bitch, I'm the best, 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 best. Way too blessed, 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 blessed. No matter why I try, 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 you could never be me, never I. Keep petting from the side. day, first thing in the morning. When I wake up, thank God for life. Look in the mirror, say, bitch, I'm the best, best, best.
Juhnay is so amazing.
I love it. Being
that was
outdoors.
their first digital drag number, they told me.
Really?
That's a really good one.
Now, good comments about the outfit and makeup really matching on point.
Yes, yes. She looks amazing. Totally.
So, now I don't know if everybody knows this, but there's been a drink explosion.
Bartender error.
Okay, I was waiting for that. So, I don't know if everybody knows this, but my two business partners at Oasis, Jeff and Heklina, have stepped away from the club, and I've bought them out, and I am now the business lady owner of Oasis.
She makes us clap when we enter the room.
Shut up.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
We're all trapped. She's kept us all trapped down here in her basement.
But, you know, it was, scary to have them go because we had built it together. But I'm really excited to grab the torch and run with it. And excited about what Oasis 2.0 can look like coming out of this time. So, Snacks and I are working hard at different ideas of both a slow re-entry and a big grand opening with a lot of
lube.
Yes, a lot of new fun and diverse entertainment. So
totally,
it's been a challenge to have it all happen during this time, but I'm excited to see what the future holds.
Do you want to talk about the event that we're doing next week or not yet? Meals on Heels.
Let's first discuss the fact that everyone's talking about your pony. And so is it real or not real? They're
okay,
asking.
So here's the thing, everybody. Let's not ask black people about their hair anymore, okay?
Yes.
I'm just kidding. This is
especially
definitely a fake ponytail. I probably got it from Walgreens. Walgreens makes like a ponytail. It's like $19.99. Or maybe Amazon. Although, I know we shouldn't be shopping on Amazon. So I'll just pretend like I got it somewhere else.
Fashion Nova should do hair pieces.
Oh my God. Can you imagine? Fashion Nova is just like the new Walmart or Costco. It's just like everything you could ever buy is like you get it from Fashion Nova.
Next week on Hot Trash, Snacks and I are going to do a Fashion Nova fashion show.
We are.
And the truth is, and it's the reality as well, that we have some of the exact same outfits.
We do. It's true.
Twinsies.
Yes. And it's funny because Darcy will be like, oh, no, I bought, like, all these new outfits as I'm, like, sitting on my computer like, oh, no, like, what are you talking about? Well, did you know there was 80% off today? It's a fraud. There's always a discount.
I know, but can we talk about the fact that you literally... I've ordered it and it has come the next day.
It's crazy.
Like literally, I have
even during quarantine
ordered like a lot. Like,
yeah,
I'm embarrassed to say, maybe 10 dresses, and literally 24 hours later, maybe 26 hours, but they're on my doorstep.
Yes, even during quarantine. I mean,
well,
we shouldn't be supporting Fashion Nova.
I understand that. I understand that. So I'm sorry, actually. And I'll use this time to apologize for
our shopping addiction.
I wish that somebody could come up with a Fashion Nova-esque. I guess you couldn't get it. So, I'm digging myself deeper.
That's the whole problem with fast fashion, am I right? I mean, the reason that it's so cheap is because it's of the way that
all right, I'm sorry. Anyway. All right. We're not going to... Are we committing to ordering no more Fashion Nova?
Are you asking that live on camera, right?
Sorry.
We're going to do our best to... Well, you know what we can do? Here's something we can do. Something we can do is...
Buy the clothes and then return them?
No, that's not what I was going to say.
Where?
I was
going to
say, put our Fashion Nova addiction in a little shame box of things that we are long-term working on. Okay. And meanwhile, support local Black artists and local queer artists and local queer and Black and fashion designers and people that are creators.
Let's make a commitment right now. So we've been posting in the Oasis newsletter resources for Black Lives Matter during this. Why don't we maybe this week or next week do a bit of do links for businesses,
great,
Black-owned businesses, and clothing lines that we could all support.
Yeah,
that'd be fun to find those out because I'd like to support more of them.
Totally. Yes. There's a I started to make an ad for this show and then ran out of time, but I started gathering Instagrams that you should be following. So maybe I'll eventually put that together and then I can post that somewhere. But Shade, SHEA_D, is an app that you can download that shows where the local businesses are that are Black owned.
Can we put that in the
chat? Yeah, SHEA_D. So, and it's an app that you can download.
Shade.
So
throw some shade.
Throw some shade at Shade, okay.
All right, who's next? All right, should we do our... Do you have an anecdotal story about this queen?
I can, but you go first. Let's do our formula. Okay. Do you have anything to say?
Yes!
Oh my God, do you have anything to say?
Oh my God, I love this queen too.
Can we please?
We've known each other for a long time. Again, performed together on the Oasis stage, and also in Star Trek before. And we had a really fun time doing a Spice Girls tribute at, what was that comedy festival?
Not Sketch Fest.
It was part of the bigger one. Anyway, we did a really fun Spice Girls reunion together. So,
Drag Race?
Well, no, it wasn't that. But anyway...
But she was on Drag Race.
She was on Drag Race. Yes.
I think that's what Jimmy was saying.
Okay, yes. And she was on Drag Race. One of our two San Francisco drag racers. And has been such a... I've loved watching this queen kind of blossom into local politics. Uh-huh. And yes. Is... I'm excited for the day I can elect Mayor Honey Mahogany.
Woo!
Sorry, well, spoiler alert, that's what we're talking about.
It's in our formula, because we're not going to tell a story, and no one's going to be paying attention.
I know, no, listen.
It doesn't
listen,
matter. Anyway.
Look, I'm going to try to look at you really hard to make it feel like people are paying attention. Can everyone
stop scaring me? I don't really like this. Are we all in the same, this is what it's like when you're in the same viral circle? No, all I was going to say about her is that she's been really, all my interactions with her have been really great. We did a Saved by the Bell table read together.
I forgot about that one, yeah.
2 weeks ago, and she was so wonderful to work with. And she's also one of the owners of The Stud, one of the owners of The Collective that, you know, made it the place that it was for the last few years when they took over The Collective. And we're so excited for our friends at The Stud to find a new home. Hopefully it's still near us in the Soma, but, you know.
Yes, keep Soma queer.
Please stay in Soma as much as possible.
And an amazing singing voice.
Oh, yeah, gorgeous. That's what she's going to do today.
I know. So I want to give, that's a special shout out.
Absolutely. Absolutely. She's incredible. And all she's right. Gorgeous, but
yes,
know, all of
yes.
Our performers are gorgeous. So.
All right. Without further ado, ladies and gentle ladies, give it up for...
Honey Mahogany!
my God, that was so gorgeous.
I know, she's incredible. I love her.
Yeah, really.
And so
really.
Beautiful. I said that already.
And soulful.
Honey, I have a crush on you. Sorry.
No, so such a great shining light. I love that person.
Yes, I agree.
And don't forget to tip these queens.
Yes.
If you're just tuning in, tip these queens. It really does make a difference.
Yes. That's something we're supposed to be doing all the time that we're not doing enough of. But it's our first one. We're learning. But yes, the suggested donation is $10 if you're just tuning in. The $10 is going to both the Black Trans Advocacy Coalition as well as the No Justice, No Peace SF Fund. And then all of the performers' Venmos are up for you to tip them as well.
We see those during each person's number.
That's right. That's right, mama.
Okay, mama.
Okay. Are you going to do it?
Oh, I'm practicing. Oh, I did it, so enough.
Sometimes she does it really well, and sometimes... It's like that.
I can't. I somehow I don't have that gene to be able to do that.
Like
no, because you can do it sometimes. This is, again, why we have to be in the same viral circle.
Yeah, that's but true. That's
anyway, true. Yeah, so please tip us at being Oasis and tip your performers.
Yes. What else? Oh, so last week we did... Meals on Heels, where we delivered delicious food and drinks to people.
Yeah.
And we did a social distancing curbside drag number, a drag show, a lip sync for everyone who got delivery. We're going to do this again. It was a lot of fun and a great success. We're also going to have lip syncs when you pick up your food too. So pick up option. You'll get a lip sync at Oasis, social distanced, of course.
Right.
So here's the thing. We're switching over to a brand new ordering service. It'll make it a lot easier. It's going to be Toast. And that's going to be up real soon. And we will give you all a shout out when we have all the deets for the next time we're going to do it.
Yes. That just made me think.
What?
There's a strip club. I forget where it is, but they are having a drive-through strip
service. Portland,
is
Oregon.
It in Portland? That just kind of made me think of like kind of that's the vibe we're going for.
Yeah. So basically, in the strip show, you drive into a tent. A stripper strips for you. You throw some money in a bucket and then drive off. It'll be the drag version of that. Okay, they're trying to wrap us up here. We gotta. Like,
oh my goodness, we haven't even gotten started. I have so much more to say on this break before
know,
our next
I
number.
I know. We gotta move on.
Okay.
Should we
okay.
do our shtick?
Yes, let's
right.
do it.
I love this performer. Such a fierce queen, can just own the stage. Really inspired by every performance I've seen, and has, to my knowledge, the most wig reveals that I've ever seen in one number. So I'm really happy that she's part of this as well. Take it away, Snacks!
Me too. I'm super excited. I wasn't sure what number they were going to give us for the show, and honestly, any of them would have been incredible, but this one I'm super excited about because it's a live one, meaning it's a recording of them performing live as opposed to a digital drag. And digital drag is so much fun, and I'm so happy that we have this medium, but don't sigh like that. I promise I'll wrap up quickly. But the live numbers is kind of like remembering what once was, you know, when we could be on stage and have an audience. So it's exciting to watch a few live numbers, and there's a few mixed in tonight. But the first one is, of course, the fabulous
Nicki Jizz!
Colors for you. and everything that you do. I don't really need to look very much further. I don't wanna have to go where you don't follow. I won't hold it back again. This passion inside can't run, run from myself. There's no
ridiculous. I mean, she went viral.
Yeah, that was like around the world.
One of the more, I mean,
oh, she's Nicki, viral too. We could, she could be our
she
circle.
Could be in our viral circle. She's too famous for us. but that number, I mean, Nicki Jizz has gone viral more than once.
When you rip a bald, your bald head in half and show another wig, it's like, it's the ultimate reveal.
Completely. I said in the chat just now, I was like, go home. I know everyone's home. Leave your house and then go home again. Just go home. Yeah, we're done. Yeah.
I hope that queen got some tips.
Yes. Tip Nicki Jizz.
So
for reparations.
Lorraine says she misses hanging out with you in a club and having you spill your drinks all over her.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to be Lorraine, but I would, so I would, I if you want to spill a drink on me to make Lorraine feel good.
So can I just tell you that my best friend Lorraine watches all of my drag shows just to troll me and does this. It doesn't matter like what medium we're using. She comes on and then she does this.
She trolls you.
She trolls me all the time. So yes. Like, so now Darcy wants to spill a drink on me.
No. You have to spill the drink on me. I would be giving up my caftan.
Do it.
I could never.
All right. Sorry.
We'll wait for it to happen on accident.
Sorry, Lorraine.
It'll definitely happen on accident later. So.
But if you're interested in me spilling a drink on snacks, I'd be more than happy to do that.
I almost wish that we had two different Venmos up so that we could have a
Who got the most money?
Next time we host a show together, whoever has the most money will do spill a drink on the other.
Yeah. Though I have a sinking suspicion. Is it a sinking or a stinking?
It's not either of those.
A sneaking. Is it a sneaking suspicion?
No.
I have suspicion.
It's a stinky suspicion.
That you would win because everyone wants you to throw a drink in my face.
Wow.
Did you like how spilling a drink turned into throwing in my face? I can't believe
I'm
you.
I'm going to do a
You are so rude. Oh, God.
Oasis,
okay.
Right now is
like
snacks
for
Darcy.
Oh my God! No! We gotta go to commercial.
Oh my God! Okay.
Commercial.
So we built in a commercial, both because we want to support a commercial break,
because we want to eat the nachos.
Yes, because we want to support the ads that you're going to be seeing. I have to pee, and Darcy needs to have a bite of his quesadilla. Her quesadilla. Excuse me.
Don't disrespect my pronoun.
I said I was sorry. And I need to refill my cocktail. She's showing me her shoes. So you guys are really in for a treat for the next half, because who knows where this is going. But
maybe there'll be some more of those faux oppers.
Oh yes. We're
thanks, Coco Buttah.
For the faux oppers. In case you didn't understand the joke, that's the one she's trying to make work.
Sorry.
Stop trying to make faux oppers happen. It's not going to happen. Anyway. We're going to go to commercial. We love you all. Please tune in. Please stay here.
Yes, don't leave
we'll
us. Back. Stick around.
Don't leave us. We'll be back.
Hi, I'm Nicki Jizz. What is Juneteenth? Juneteenth is Freedom Day for Black people. Fuck your Independence Day. This is our day. The Emancipation Proclamation ain't shit. It took an extra 2 years, 6 months, and 19 days until the last slaves were set free. And we continue to fight for our freedom every day. We fight against police brutality, mass incarceration, institutionalized racism, even the right to have our own natural hair. But we're gonna celebrate Juneteenth. How you say? With reparations. Reparations, a drag show, hosted by me, Nicki Jizz. Remember, reparations, Friday, June 19th. Be there or be racist.
Thank you.
no.
Nothing to see here.
Nothing. Nothing. We're just hosting a drag show.
So, like, usually intermission is time for people to use the restroom, smoke a cigarette, talk with their friends. But we got read. Like, they were, like, reading me about everything in the
yes.
chat.
And yes. Yeah. People are concerned about how quickly you can eat a burrito, what your jaw's capable of, whether or not you're off carbs. Caleb, we saw that.
Yeah. I have eyes. I can read Caleb.
She can't see it. She doesn't have her glasses. Yeah.
But they told me, and Sister Roma, they told me that you're coming too.
It's true. We can read all of it. Well, since we're talking about...
You know, it's when they stop talking about you is next.
True.
Is the problem.
All press is good press. Is that what they say?
Yes. And can we talk about my... I'm actually TikTok famous right now.
Oh, boy. We have to tell the story.
I thought it'd be funny and silly for Hot Trash to make a ASMR. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Try it again.
ASMR. ASMR of me eating a hamburger. And I put it on TikTok... Shut up. Shit. I can tell.
I'm not listening. Go ahead.
I know. Tell these moves.
I know. I should take it off. I thought it would be funny
just to put it on there. We'd use it in Hot Trash. Well, I had like no followers on TikTok. And suddenly it blew up in other countries. And now I have... Don't stop rolling your eyes. I'm not rolling my eyes.
You shouldn't be looking at the screen. You're still feeling in the camera.
I have 360,000 views of me eating a cheeseburger.
Wow!
Close up. I know. But here's the problem. Most of them... Now, they're in another language, so I couldn't tell what they were. So I Google translated. I could tell they were bad because of the FU emojis, the pig emojis, the throw up emojis. And I translated them. A lot of them, can I say the F word on this?
Yeah.
Yes.
A lot of them said, fuck you, fuck off, eat shit and die. One of them said, shut your mouth,
so normal
you dirty
fan
old lady.
Like,
yes.
Celebrity.
But
wait,
you know
that's my
what?
Favorite. Shut your mouth, you dirty old lady.
Passing, right here, 24/7. So here's the thing, though. It's, again, I'm TikTok famous. They may be haters. But have you ever had 361,000 views? I don't think so, no.
You don't know anything about TikTok.
So follow me on TikTok. I think I might eat a cake on Tuesday with no utensils. So we're going to have a TikTok premiere. Okay, now sorry.
Wait, can I talk about myself a little bit? Because
Reveals.
I want to make a joke.
Okay.
So I took my vest off. I've been outside tanning by my trash cans almost every day.
The girls.
It's part of my quarantine routine, my girls. But the funny part is that look how white my belly is.
Oh,
and so
wow.
I'm like totally like Kim. I know I'm totally like Kim Kardashian. Did you see that video of her when she was like, "Oh, don't judge my pale hand," because her face was super dark. And it's like, "Bitch, you are white. Like, get a grip." Although now I'm reading myself because what color my belly
is. I thought you were wearing a shaper, and I thought your shaper didn't match your skin.
I'm not wearing a shaper, girl. This is all belly, and it's all white, and it's all right,
okay.
I guess. I don't
all
know.
Right. Okay.
Anyway, that's where we're at right now, back from commercial break. do we want to move on to the next? Oh, no, wait. I'm sorry. We're supposed to do one more thing. We want to really quickly thank everyone who's helped us make the show happen. Sean Frank is our designer that made all of our art and is running our live stream.
Amazing.
What is it called? Murray House Productions?
Yeah.
What?
Yes.
Murray House
Productions.
Yeah, that one. Murray House Productions, where we're streaming
thank
from
you.
That are so generous to just lend us their basement to do this stream from. Can you not check your phone while we're live?
My TikTok is blowing up. My TikTok is blowing up.
Okay, as someone who's always on their phone, like, I have the respect.
Yeah,
to, like,
you kind of are.
Down for a second.
Yeah, you kind of are always
on your
phone.
I know, but do you
phone.
See that it's not while we're doing this? Anyway, thank you to the Murray House Productions. Thank you to all of our incredible performers who have submitted numbers for tonight, to all of our audience, everyone in the comments right now that I'm living for.
Take your top off, Caleb says.
Wow, no.
Can someone take Caleb's phone away?
Josh, are you watching? Can you take
and
Caleb's
if you
phone
are
away?
Just tuning in, this is Amplify. And
oh, yes, thank you.
It's a suggested donation of $10. All the money is going to two organizations, the Black Trans Advocacy Coalition, excuse me, and No Justice, No Peace Fund. So your $10 donation, if you want to give more to those organizations, bring it on. 100% is going to them. And then each of the performers has their Venmo or their way of giving them money directly. So tip a queen. They deserve it. And honestly, just coming from, one herself, it really does make a big difference. The money in the pocketbook is great, but having the encouragement and the validation from our community really does make a difference. I just want to say one more thing, if I could.
Please.
And
I don't have anywhere to be. I'm good.
I also think, I want to talk about hope for a minute.
Great.
Because these times are really intense and really dark, and I find myself pissed off a lot. Like, it's really hard to be on social media and not get angry when you see videos of what's going on and just the real, like, fucked up way that our government is working at the moment. So it feels dark and hopeless, but hope is something I think is very important. Hope means that you believe that we can solve this. And I do believe that we can get through this and we can solve it. It's going to take a lot of time and it's going to take a lot of work. But if you have hope, you have belief in the future. And that is enough to keep on going and to persevere. And I think that perseverance is the key right now in all of this. And hope is contagious. And if we are hopeful and we believe that the future can get better, we can inspire other people to be hopeful. And that hope will give everybody perseverance, because it'll be real easy to stop protesting, stop standing up, stop using our voice, and we can't. So hope is the key. So be hopeful, find that hope for you, find that hope, and inspire other people to be hopeful, because then I think we can really, really solidify a change.
Yes, and I think...
Sorry, my soapbox.
I love it, and I agree. I think the hope has to be actionable. I think that you have to believe, and that's where it starts, but I think that it only can get you so far if you're not taking action.
Yes.
If you're not signing the petitions, if you're not going to the marches, if you're not donating the money, if you're not uplifting Black voices, those are the actionable items that your hope needs to be.
Absolutely. But I think I think that does give you the energy to be like, I'm going to keep showing up
completely
to those protests. I'm going to keep signing the petitions because I believe we can get, because
completely.
What I hate to see is people just be like, fuck it.
Yeah.
It's like useless.
Yeah.
And like giving up is not going to change anything.
No. Now taking a break and taking care of yourself is important. Yes.
We're getting played off.
Taking care of yourself and taking a break and self-care is crucial. But yes, giving up is not an option. It's not an option.
Who wants some drag?
Now there's more drag numbers. We are going to go to our next performer. Do you want to do your spiel?
Well, I love this queen. She actually was in Star Trek once, too. She killed it. She is an amazing friend and an amazing singer and performer. And this bitch has been around. She is an institution in San Francisco. So, again, I was really happy when she said yes to be part of this.
Yeah, I agree. She's an OG. And I mean that as a compliment. She's been around for a long time and is a super important pillar of the San Francisco drag community. So let's give it up for
BeBe Sweetbriar!
I've tried that love thing for the last time. city, the heaven sent to fulfill my need. But when I turn around, again love has not been down. My heart got broken, no, it hurt so bad. I'm sad to say love wins again.
So I place my heart under lock and key. Take care of me.
But I turn around and you're standing here.
How did you get here? Nobody's supposed to be here.
Nobody's supposed to be here.
I've tried that nothing for the last time.
My heart said
no, no,
no.
Nobody's supposed to.
Technically challenged.
I actually think you keep apologizing for this, and I don't think you should.
Okay, never mind.
I'm
not sorry.
I think that, yes, we may not know how to do all the fabulous stuff that Sean Frank is doing behind the camera, but we spend so much time kibitzing with each other during the day. Is that a word? Is that Yiddish?
I don't know what you just said.
we do this already. Our banter.
Yes.
It happens
in reality.
So
totally.
We just do it in front.
No, totally. I just am excited that this is our first drag show that we're doing live virtually.
Yes.
And
I appreciate it too. It's fun. And I think we could do more. And I wonder, if we got it. Yeah. Someday maybe we could do it from the Oasis stage.
That would be great. Before we can have a natural audience.
Yeah,
there.
We could even put fake people in the audience so it can feel like a real. We could have anyone we want in the audience. Madonna. could come to see us.
Is that who your goal? Who, if you could have anyone come and watch you do a drag show?
Anyone? Madonna? Come. No. I was just, people like her. So. Well, I think they do. People, her fans are still her fans.
Okay.
I mean, do you all still love Madonna? I mean, I don't know.
Ever since tell us in the comments.
I mean, who would I love to come? Who would you love to come? Well, you'd love Lizzo.
I would love her.
I would love Lizzo to come.
I mean, can you imagine if Prince? I mean, I know R.I.P. But like, can you imagine if Prince came to a drag show at Oasis?
Well, I would. I the fucking pressure. Guy. The pressure that I would be under.
Now that would be scary.
People are saying meh to Madonna.
Okay, yeah. Meh to Madonna. What about
people like Madonna, Darcy Trollinger. That's amazing.
Well, like, yeah, they do, don't they? I don't know.
Maybe I don't know.
Prince.
How about Robin? I would like Robin.
Oh,
to
sure. Robin would be fun. She could DJ though.
Absolutely.
She could do DJ.
And
set.
I think she would have fun. I remember when Cindy Wilson from the B-52s came for B-52s night, and she had a blast.
Yeah.
Like, I would want... okay, we're trying to wrap it up.
Well, no, and I had something else to talk about during the segment anyway. What I wanted to
Leslie
talk about
Jordan.
Was... Oh, Leslie Jordan? Sure, that would be great. Does someone say that in the comments?
No, someone
outside here. Can we talk also about why on Drag Race Madison Beer has become, like, the new... Why is she on all of the episodes? Anyway, it doesn't matter.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
That's not what I wanted to talk about. What I wanted to talk about was, since we are at Murray International Filming Institute, what is it called?
We gotta wrap this up.
Sorry. Really quick, the lovely people that are producing or helping us produce our show... Are also produced Drunk Drag Broadway.
Yes.
Drunk Drag Broadway used to perform at Oasis when we were able to perform on stage.
Will again.
And Will again, RIP, but maybe not forever. Rise from the dead.
Oh my God. Yeah, like a phoenix
exactly.
from the flames.
Exactly.
Not like the Day of the Dead. I'm sorry. Like, no zombie drag show.
No, not zombie drag show.
That would be one night
maybe
only.
Maybe we will do a zombie drag show.
Fabulous.
Anyway, you know, I did the... that song Zombie in Russian one time. For
really? Whoa. Why were you Russian? You should have slowed down a little bit.
You know what? It doesn't matter. Let's move on.
No,
I'll talk about other people.
No,
that was too good. That was really great, Darcy. I wasn't ready for that one.
I'm sorry.
And I'm usually ready.
I
usually see him coming.
I know.
I wasn't ready for that one. That was a good one.
Let's move on.
We love Drunk Drag Broadway. They film from here, and I will be doing a show July 3rd with them.
July 3rd?
That is
July 3rd.
Another opportunity for uplifting Black voices and especially Black people in the theater and drag community. So very excited for that show. So stay tuned for more details about that.
Amazing singers on that show.
Yes.
All right.
Okay, so the next performer, let's do our thing. Go ahead.
Well, again, I am always in awe of this performer. Owning the stage, I haven't known this performer for that long, but every single time nails it, brings it, giant audience favorite. So I am a little jealous of this queen because she's got it. So I'm super excited that she said yes to be part of this, and I can't wait to get her back on the Oasis stage.
Absolutely. Yeah, I was rewatching some old stage performances today from Oasis and watched almost 7 minute number that they did. Ooh, excuse me. An almost 7 minute number that they did, and it is beyond captivating. Like, they have to be on Drag Race immediately. Like, there's no reason why they should not be, like, the next uplifted spokesperson for San Francisco drag, because they are so incredible all the time. And I love them very dearly, and they're an incredible singer and dancer and performer. So let's hear it for Militia Towers!
Lots of people think Ariana is appropriating Black culture. If you don't know what that means, it's the inappropriate adaption of practices, ideas of people or society by members of another and typically more dominant people or society. Now, I'm gonna just sum that up because it was a lot of words. I'm just gonna say that it's the act of taking advantage of someone's culture for your own personal benefit, whether it's popular or not. Spotify has recently added Ariana to a playlist called Black History Is Now.
I could do more, and I realize that I don't do enough. And I think it's age, too. I'm older than I look. You know, I'm black, so you'll never know. But it's happening. It's setting in where you say the wrong things, you don't know stuff. I'm not as woke as I should be, and it's embarrassing. Like, I've been messing up on my pronouns lately. Because I met someone who was not a guy or a girl. They were a they. Which is how they wanted to be referred to, and that's important. Like, I care about that. It's just, it's new to me. And in a sentence, structurally, it makes me sound like a runaway slave. Like, where they at? Bates come? They down by the river. They gonna be mad at that joke.
Broken heart.
amazing.
Militia, I miss you. You're so good.
Really, really amazing.
I mean, no one captivates a whole stage or can take up a whole stage like Militia. It's just.
I mean,
tired.
Give the bitch some tips.
Yeah.
Tip a queen.
Tip a queen. Militia SF. You saw it during her number.
The
it was
whole
up on
time.
The screen.
You got all handles everywhere.
Militia SF. Tip that bitch. I love her. Oh, also, sorry. We meant to mention it earlier. If you're in the chat, hopefully you saw. Janae was talking about where she got her garment made for her number. And it sounded like it was, I forget exactly what she said, but it was like, a local black designer. So,
buy a dress.
Yeah. Buy a dress from them. Let's put it in the chat again. Janae, I know it looks like you're still here. So put it in there. Yes. African Violet Fashion. Fabulous. I mean, she looked amazing. So let's definitely.
Gorgeous. Yes.
Yeah. But I love Militia so much.
Me too.
Militia Doesn't Change is going to come, which, like, she just did at this, it was a protest in Castro. And I've heard her sing it before, but she did it recently, and it was amazing. Oh, no, she did Rides Up. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Everything Militia sings is amazing. So,
okay, I get it. You're in love.
I do. She's incredible.
Yeah, I agree.
I can't help it. Sorry. Anyway. What are they saying?
Performing Oasis seems like centuries ago. I know. Well, in drag queen years, 3 months is like 3 years,
yes.
3 decades.
Yes.
But I promise we'll get you back in there as soon as physically possible.
Yes. And I apologize because the person who's saying a change is going to come is actually our next performer. They are, do we want to do our thing?
Well, I would love to do the thing, but like, I don't know this performer very
totally.
Well.
Totally. They've not been on the Oasis stage as far as I know.
I'm super duper excited. I mean, I've heard so many amazing things and the video is great. So I can't wait to become better acquainted with this performer.
Oh my.
well,
yes,
that's my go-to. It's my go-to.
That's great. Me and this performer did the same round of Turbo Pageant. So that's something that used to happen on stage at the Stud, hosted by Nicki Jizz and Florida Man. That was a 4-week competition that they decided to do virtually. I suggested it on Twitter, just for what it's worth.
Oh, so it's all due to you.
That's not what I'm saying. All I'm saying is, I was like, Florida was like, I don't think we should do it. And I was like, I think you should.
Well,
and then
everything.
That's
changed.
All I'm saying. I'm not saying I'm responsible. I'm not saying that I am. What's the
right?
Anyway,
maybe you're the tipping point.
Correct.
The tipping point.
But yes,
the
this
voice
performer.
In the crowd.
Correct. This performer was in the same round of Turbo Pageant as me, and that's how I got acquainted with them. And they've just completely exploded. Literally, you know that you really like something that someone has to say when every time you open Facebook, their post is at the top of your feed. This person is always at the top of my feed because
okay.
I'm just living for everything they
that.
Have to say.
Right.
So let's give it up
She's
for our
trending.
Next performer, Freddie!
Yeah! Woo!
Hi, everybody. I'm Sissy.
I'm Honey.
I'm Alton.
And I'm Baby.
And together, we're the aliens. We're going to teach you about the universe. Honey, do you know what we're exploring this week?
Uranus?
Yeah. No, silly Nelly. Today, we're going to be learning about the moon. So strap in and get ready for blast off.
We're the aliens, we're from outer space, we're here to cheer up at the Milky Way.
And now, introducing our new special friend, the moon.
I'm your guest, the moon, here's my lunar tune. No, I'm not a loon, I'm just a little dark-sided. I'm the moon, oh yeah, it's fucking cool or something.
This moon, I don't think we're supposed to say mean words on PBS.
Well, first of all, you've been doing this show since, what, the 1970s? Aren't you a bit old to be called baby? And second of all,
Wait, actually, no, that's all I was gonna say.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Miss Moon. We're real excited to have you.
Thanks for having me. I'm real excited to have a temp agency who books me without looking at my resume.
Hey, kids, are you ready for some fun facts? Our first fact of the day, did you know the moon is one of the densest satellites in our solar system?
Now, wait a minute. Who you calling dense? I might be reading at a third grade level, but I'm fucking smart, okay? Now, what's a satellite?
Did you know the moon has practically no atmosphere?
What?
She just gets pounded all day long by cosmic rays,
you're saying
solar
I get...
winds, and meteorites.
You're saying I get pounded all day? That's slander. You're making me sound like some kind of whore. Which, I'm not saying there's anything bad about it. You know, get your money, but it's just ain't me.
Did you know the moon's temperature fluctuates dramatically from ice cold to raging hot in only a matter of seconds?
Now hold the fucking phone! You're making me real mad right about now, and I don't appreciate the disrespect.
Oh, did you know the moon was created by a rock smashing into the earth?
Did you know that I'm gonna be smashing a rock into your baby's skull in a second?
You're silly, Nelly. Wait. What the fuck did this nigga just say to me?
Well, that's it. I've had it with this nigga.
That's right now. You
bitch. Get his ass.
Fuck
him up, sis.
Stupid
asshole.
They're killing me. They're killing me. They're killing me.
Yeah.
Yeah. We didn't do our thing.
Oh, the
microphone
is on. That's
Oh, no, we're back! Oh, I didn't know we were... Freddie,
oh my God, that
we
was amazing.
Love you.
That was
That number
amazing.
Is so... It's just insanity.
Yes.
And puppets, which are two components of San Francisco drag, for sure.
That was fantastic.
Yes, so good. I thought you were going to say something else.
Well... I was going to talk about who's next.
Oh, are we moving on that quickly?
Oh, we're not. We have some things to talk about.
Do we? I don't know.
Well,
do we?
Your job performance.
My job performance? Wow, what a surprise. Snacks on her phone. Yeah,
whoa.
I'm trying to stay engaged with the chat, okay, everybody?
I know. So, I was talking about you helping me. Your
oh,
job
great.
Performance with me.
Let's talk about it.
Well, okay.
Oh, am I getting a review right now?
I have some issues.
Oh my God!
Look, I had to, to get here, I had to drive myself, first of all.
I don't have a driver's license, so
okay,
I can't.
Okay, well, I thought about that. All right, so I had to drive myself. I had to find my own way here. Waze or Google Maps. And I'm driving here dressed like this, just a casual Sunday outfit. And the part of my car, like the plastic around my tire was... I look in the rearview mirror and it's flapping. Like the entire part of... Half of my car was basically about to fall off.
Oh.
So I had to pull over on Alamany Boulevard, right? I'm desperate because I don't want to have to go to the mini dealership and get a plastic
sure.
part of my car.
Sure.
And I had to get out and fix the car by myself. No one to help me. No one to flag down traffic. Dressed like this.
What did they say in the comment on your TikTok?
Shut your mouth, old lady.
Oh, no.
But that did happen, actually, ladies and gentlemen. My car almost fully fell apart on the freeway when I was driving here, and I had to pull over and somehow, with these soccer mom... kind of Karen French tips.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry. I know.
We went
They're
there.
So basic. They're so
I
basic.
I was not going to call you a Karen either.
Okay. Well, I don't think I'm a Karen. I just have...
Karen nails.
Someone said these were Karen nails, and I basically, when they stopped making them, I bought every pack you could possibly buy online.
I know that.
I'm not a hoarder. I just...
She's really self-incriminating. I haven't said anything, and she's just going on and on about
all right.
this.
Because I'm trying to deflect, because you're our next performer.
Oh, that's right. I am.
See, I was actually doing that on purpose.
For what?
Well, I didn't want to make you feel uncomfortable.
About what?
Well, that I was going to be talking about how fabulous you were.
Oh,
I had to bring you down a notch to build you back up.
God!
I know, I'm kidding.
It sounds like Stockholm Syndrome.
No, you know what it was? I should be able to fix my own car. False nails, moo-moo, you know, or not.
It must be nice to be able to drive. Let's talk about the police for a little bit.
Let's not.
Defund the police. Abolish the police system. Let's just get rid of it. Yes. We don't need to go into it anymore.
And rebuild it. Rebuild it and how it should be. Well, or not.
Oh, boy. Okay, we're going to have a conversation during our next our next... Well, go ahead.
You're so. Let's.
Am I allowed to tell an anecdote about myself?
Let's see. Maybe we should do it the other way.
Should we? Well, the next performer is me. The only reason I want to preface my
anecdote.
Number. No, I'm not going
to
tell an anecdote.
How much you like yourself?
That's not what I'm going to do. I'm just going to say that I'm excited because my number is another number from the Oasis stage, and like some of our comments said, we are. Super happy to be able to show a few numbers from the Oasis stage because we miss the space so much.
And I'm going to say, I love this next queen. Don't pretend like you don't know who it is
okay.
yet. I love this next queen. I feel like she is hilarious and heartfelt at the same time. I mean, again, I know her very intimately, but she's wacky. And to the point of, like, I remember one time someone sent a video. She went to go see her friend's drag show, and she fell asleep in the audience. And you know, the hilarity. And then can show up on stage, lip sync, a great lip sync, or sing live and, like, really bring the house down. She's also just one of the best people I know. So I
feel
lucky to... have her as a work colleague, as a friend, and as a performance colleague. So, and I think you have still not even hit your crowning moment, and you are still so fabulous. So,
thank you, dear.
I love snacks.
I love you too, babe.
And we're gonna watch a number, her number, and she's gonna pee. Well, that happens.
I'm going to go pee right now.
In the number.
Not during the number. Not on
hit it, DJ!
Miss Star Search 2019, on the stage she won that pageant just earlier this year. She's one of my best friends, and I really love her dearly. I'm so excited for you to see this number. Give it up for Snacks!
We will be.
we know of, asked permission to fly the rainbow flag in celebration of Pride Month and were told that they would not allowed to do so.
More kids are being separated from their parents and temporarily housed in what are essentially summer camps.
Says she was trying to raise money to help her mom, who recently lost her job, and go to Disneyland.
But how do you stop these people? You can't. There's no. That's only in the panhandle you can get away with that stuff.
It's so fun to see everyone together, but it feels kind of a little strange, doesn't it, to see everyone, no masks, that close together?
Totally.
So weird how 3 months can feel like so long.
I know. It's sad, really. And that number, not to be too much like whatever, but I did that number probably over a year ago, and it's really sad to watch so much of that struggle still be super active and super prevalent. And to have so many people in that number that I love so much. I mean, Vera and Scroto and Coco and Amy Fan, Hennessy Williams and Roma Holiday. And look, I'm going to leave people out. They're going to be mad. Ileana and Reed, Joya. I don't know.
Tip snacks. Tip snacks.
Yeah. I'm just gonna donate my tips back. Yeah, totally. I'm donating my tips to the fund. But you know, that is one really powerful thing that is super crucial about drag, is that I absolutely feel that as drag performers we have a responsibility to push the universe forward. To push the universe forward and to push you know, legislation forward and to fight for equality for everybody. And so, you know, without getting into it too much, I know there's some dissent in the theater and the drag community and people being called out, but I think honestly, like, you have to be 100% behind this at this time. It's super crucial to be 100% behind this movement and to be doing everything you can as performers to move things forward.
Yes. I mean, it is a critical juncture and the momentum is there. I agree. So yes. It is 100% time of action and using your own personal platform to rile the troops, to educate, to, you know, people are paying attention to you and as a performer.
Totally.
And you know, you may do a lip sync that isn't political or some comedy, but you have an audience. And I think for all performers, you know, it is the time of action. But for all people, it is the time of action. And if we don't let up, things will change.
Completely. Yes. Also, Piranha is in my number. Apologies. I told you I was going to forget people, and I didn't intend to.
Wow, Snacks.
I know. I'm sorry.
She did fall asleep during a drag show.
Once. Okay. Anyway, we have one performer left, everybody. Yay! We're almost at the end.
Thank you for sticking with us. We might have talked a lot.
Sorry. I know. Hopefully, we won't get canceled over anything we've said tonight. We'll see. Who knows?
Good intentions.
Only get us so far. But our last performer is Fabulous Fabulous. Go ahead.
Yes. Again, a total inspiration and totally, I feel like such a true individual. Every number is so unique, and I'm always so inspired how they are willing to push it forward in whatever theme they're doing in such a amazing commitment. So true artist, and I'm always in awe.
It's true, and Darcy and I have had many conversations about this performer specifically and about how eloquent their voice always is and how kind and just fun and jovial this person is, but also like to have such a powerful voice and to have such a strong statement. And one of my favorite things that they've ever done, which they're not showing tonight, but one of my favorite things they've ever done is a performance to Janelle Monáe to Pink. And I still want to produce. I will throw all my money at this performer to produce a Janelle Monáe night and do just all of Dirty Computer. Is that what the album's called?
Yep.
That's what the album's called. To do that whole album as a number, because they're just, that would be so incredible to see. So let's give it up for
KaiKai
Bee Michaels!
I'm so wide for it, seen it, tried it, I die fully on my terms when I get my lessons learned. Apples, cherries, pain, breathe in, pain, no, Novocaine, still maintain my grace. How come the more you have, the more that people want from you? More you burn away, the more that people earn from you. More you pull away, the more that they depend on you. I never seen a hero like me in a sci-fi. So I wonder if you need to re-remember me. I wonder if you think that I can ever raise you up. I wonder if you think that I can ever help you fly. I never seen a hero like me in a sci-fi.
Yeah.
was amazing.
Yes, that was
Thank you, KaiKai.
We love FK Twigs.
Give KaiKai a tip.
Tip them. Give them all your money. Oh, I do have to... for 1 second. So I've been tanning, like I said, out in my backyard by my garbage can.
Are you sure you've been rubbing, tanning?
Well, no, no. Lotion? That's what's so funny is I just noticed, like, I'm always sitting facing towards the sun. So, like, the back of my arms are, like, so pale. Because I've only been sitting like this to, like, tan. Okay, anyway, it doesn't matter. This is the end of our show.
Thank you all so much for tuning in.
Yeah.
Woo! Thank you all so much. Thank you for hanging with us for, what, oh, do we do 2 hours?
2 hours.
Well, we had a lot to say.
yeah, so thanks for spending time with us, especially for those of you who, like, stuck around for the whole thing.
Totally.
Sister Roma did spend me money to try and do my au clair one more time.
Let's hear it.
All right. me. Oh, that was pretty good.
Yeah.
That's kind of best I've ever done. It wasn't good. Oh,
it's only going to get worse. It's only going to get worse. Let's cut the stream. But truly, thank you all so much. You can donate still the rest of the night at Oasis SF to raise money for our organizations. All of the... performers' tips are going to be in the thing, right?
In the chat.
So, you can look at
so tip the performers again. Hopefully you've been drinking and now you feel more generous. Tip them again. Thank you to all of our performers tonight.
Yes.
We are so honored for you to be a part of this. And this was fun. We should do it again.
This was super fun. And we will do it again. If they'll invite us back here after the shenanigans.
Totally.
And thank you so much. And we want to see you back at Oasis as soon as physically possible. We will let you know as soon as we can get the doors open in some capacity.
Yes. Until then, we love you all. Thank you.
Love you. Good night.
Bye. 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 Bye.